Hello everybody, my name is Harvey and today I will go through the four basic types of encryption that can be used with the DrayTek Smart VPN remote dial-in client. The screen shows the four types of encryption we will demonstrate. We now have a 3910 DrayTek router. We check if the WAN IP is available. Then we go to the VPN Remote Access Control tab to enable the encryption type we will be using. For security reasons, it is recommended to untick all those unused types, but for this demo, we will leave them all activated. After that, we go to the Remote Dial-in User tab and tick Enable this account. Then select the dial-in type. Again, please untick all unused encryption types. Then fill in a username and password if necessary. And then select a LAN subnet for the user dialing in, either that or assign it an IP address. Click OK to save the profile on the VPN server. Now that the VPN server is set up to receive a VPN call, we will now configure the Smart VPN client to use PPTP encryption. So we open the Smart VPN, go to the Profile tab, add a profile name, call it PPTP1, and enter the IP address of the VPN server. We will get the IP address from the router. Going back to the Edit Profile window, now we enter the username and password. We select this type as PPTP from a list which we can choose from a drop-down menu. You can see the different choices we have here and click OK. We will now start a continuous ping to the VPN server LAN IP address, which is 192.168.1.1. We then slide the switch to the connect position. We get a pop-up window. Confirm the username and password, and then we click OK. Here we have our VPN tunnel started. The pop-up window disappears, and the ping starts to get replies, showing that the PPTP VPN tunnel is up and running. We will now move to the next encryption type, which is SSL. Again, we open the Smart VPN client and add a new profile. We type in the VPN server IP as usual and make sure that the SSL type is selected. Then we type in the username and password. Here we can also set up manually an IP address and DNS server for the tunnel instead of having it done automatically. Then we slide the switch to connect, launch our continuous ping to 192.168.1.1. and click OK to start the VPN. We wait till the pop-up window disappears and the ping gets replies confirming that the VPN tunnel is up and running. We can now go to the VPN connection management page of the VPN server and check that the SSL tunnel is up and is displayed in green, which means that the data is encrypted. We will now move to the L2TP over Ipsec encryption and still use the Smart VPN client. So here again, we make sure that the encryption type is L2TP over Ipsec. Enter the IP address of the VPN server and type in the username and password. You may also assign manually an IP address for the VPN tunnel and check the advanced options for the security method. For this demo, we have used the high settings, which is ESP, and to do this, we have to enter the IPsec mode, and then select the high security settings, as well as enter the pre-shared key. Then we slide the switch to start the VPN, and wait for the pop-up window to disappear, and for the replies to the ping appears. You can also go to the VPN connection manager and check that the VPN tunnel is up and running. Now we will tackle the last type of encryption, which is the IPsec one. So again, we will add a new profile and call it IPsec test. Select the IPsec type. Enter the VPN server IP address. We can also choose to add a specific static IP address for the VPN tunnel. And clicking on the advanced option, we can choose between either the medium or the high security level. We select the high ESP level and click OK. We then slide the switch to the active mode. A pop-up window will appear asking to confirm the push-it key. Then we can click OK. Waiting for the ping replies, meaning that the IPsec tunnel is up and running. We now go to the VPN connection management. We can see that the VPN is displayed in green, indicating that the data is encrypted in IPsec. Oh, I nearly forgot to show you where the pre-shared key for IPsec is entered in the VPN server. Just go to the VPN tab under IPsec General Setup and enter the pre-shared key twice. Here it is. This concludes our demo today on how to use Smart VPN clients using four different types of encryption, namely the PPTP, SSL, L2TP over IPsec, and IPsec encryption. Thank you for your kind attention.